Hello everyone, welcome in. This is my update. I had been asked for more videos on our high country wild cottage garden and my lazy girl method. So this is June 14th, 2024, and we are really just maybe a month in. We have such a short gardening season, and so I am going to show our progress so far. Today I watered and worked in the garden, and then I rode my bike to town, and these beautiful butterflies kept flying along with me, accompanying me all along the way. It was really fun and beautiful and interesting. So all of our flowers through the years, we've been doing this for over 25 years. And it's a favorite time of year and our favorite place to be. So we're having big, beautiful bouquets of fragrant heavenly peonies right now. And this was a few weeks ago, when I was just starting to work the beds and waiting to see what reseeded itself and what the perennials were going to do, and starting to plan again what I wanted to plant and start inside. And I have to kind of put all kinds of flashy fun stuff around the garden to keep the critters away from our seedlings till they get a good start. So it kind of looks like a silly, crazy party in the garden, but it works. So that's what it looks like right now. And this is at the end of the summer last year, when it looks just crazy amazing, filled with flowers, veggies, greens, all mixed in together. So what I do is I figure out what I want to plant, which is usually the same large, tall things in the back row, medium things in the middle row, and short in the front, and things that can grow together and climb each other and support each other. So it's all mixed up, flowers, veggies, everything. I do want to say, if you do this, know your leaves so you don't eat a leaf that you shouldn't. So be sure and look at the packets, maybe save them, and be able to identify leaves that you might not know. Here is my old broken down rake with some of our little garden friends. They're always hanging out with us. They seem to like us. And I finally had to break down and throw away our rickety, rackety old, I don't know, 30-year-old rake, and get a great, big, wonderful new one, which helped me prepare the beds perfectly. Plastic, of course, these days. Excuse me, it's super dry. Today is really stormy and windy and cloudy, and I believe we're going to have rain. So it just feels kind of dry right now. This is our Virginia creeper, which I love, and I'm so happy it has survived. That was a few weeks ago. Here's some of our precious little seedlings coming along, and some that got kind of leggy and spindly. And have you ever heard of Egyptian walking onions? Because it's a thing, and I have some growing. Can't wait. But the little seedlings are so adorable. And everything is planted now into the garden, and I was waiting to see what reseeded. In the meantime, I'm taking a floral painting class, so I was needing to create bouquets, collecting flowers from the shops in town, and then attempting to paint them while I waited. And I can see what I need to fix in this one. It's not finished, but it's fun. It's all part of the progress, part of the process. So now things are just blowing up. These are some pretty things that the birds, hummingbirds and bees, love, and I don't even know what it is. It all reseeded itself, and that's supposed to be a walkway beside this bed. And these are all full now of some perennials, things that receded, like arugula is gone crazy and bolted, needs a lot of thinning. Our peonies are doing great this year. Mustard greens reseeded and have pretty yellow flowers because they bolt so fast. And I like to use those little blossoms from bolting greens and veggies in bouquets. So thousands of morning glories reseeded. And so I have to thin hundreds and hundreds out, but I love them, and they climb the tall things, the corn, the sunflowers, and things like that, and the stakes that I put in. That iris is not happy there. Needs to be moved, because in other places they're just thriving like crazy. All of our rose bushes are healthy, and I can hardly wait. Have several different kinds and types. So perennials, things growing in the rocks where they don't belong that I need to deal with. Lots of greens that came back on their own, reseeded. So I waited to see what all of that was going to do. I didn't need to disturb the beds because they're so fluffy still from being amended so well last year. So I didn't do any tilling or disturbing. I just smoothed off the top. I did add a little amendment, like some of our redworm compost that I keep going. That's what I have for pets, is redworms. So there is the Virginia creeper today. These things just explode so fast, from nothing to beautiful and full. 2 years ago, that Virginia creeper almost got completely eaten and killed by some nasty worms. So I'm thrilled that it's thriving again. This, I think it's vinca vine that stays as a perennial and keeps growing every year. This is a rose bush that I salvaged, saved from one of my dear friends' yards when they all had to move away, and this was the rose bush that was at her great-great-grandmother's homestead. I believe she said by the front door. So generations have been trying to save starts, and the new owners of the place just have let it all die off. So I'm really happy that I'm saving some and going to figure out how to get some to my friend of her family's heirloom rose bush. The little roses are the most beautiful pink, and the fragrance is divine. So more peony pots, houseplants come out and sit for the summer. And there's our crazy grapevine climbing up the wall. There's the precious little first rosebud on my friend's heirloom that I'm becoming a nursery for. Peonies, cosmos, a really fun purple columbine. The greenhouse is well on its way. I'm still working on it. And this is a rose. Actually, this is two roses. One, they're both purple. One, a friend gave us in memory of our son 2 years ago. Little hummers that come and visit. Our yummy little translucent champagne grapes. We made wine last year. It's not that great, but we'll keep learning. Some of the iris that are just starting to open. More garden friends. And we love them, except the ones that chomp down on our greens, like has happened here. And I'm going to find them and deal with them. So parsley perennialed over the winter, which is amazing in several places. lots of cilantro. Some of our peonies explode with blooms and some don't. Citronella plants to help keep bunnies and some bugs away, planted throughout. And I have salvaged some of our squash seeds from years before and replanted those, and they're popping up, not all of them, but most of them. So from nothing a few weeks ago to this, already, it's hard to keep up with all the greens. Have to make lots of salads and cook lots of greens up. And I like to make juice as well with the greens and a little arugula, cucumber, lemon, apple, delicious. There's our grapevine thriving. It already has lots of clusters of little tiny grapes all over it. Here's one of our David Austin rose bushes that I'm fighting aphids on. Here are spent iris, and I think they're beautiful even when they're spent and dried and curled up. More squash that need to be thinned. This is the two roses. One is a deep purple and one's a lavender color, and I'm trying to train them up onto this form, which is four shepherd's hooks, but I want them to grow up like the roses that we saw in when we visited Monet's garden in Giverny, and I want them to hopefully train up to look like they do on these forms that they have in their garden there that look like this. It would be so beautiful. So I'll see what happens. But that was a beautiful day in Monet's beautiful garden. This is just one of the pictures I took and played with in a painterly app, which I think will be helpful in seeing how I would like to paint florals. I'm trying to find my style more in the beautiful garden at Monet's home that he planned. He liked it really wild, but his wife wanted it nice and neat. But he went out. He went out and painted every day. He had many gardeners. If you would like to hear a lot about it, listen to the Good Life France podcast. And just a few weeks ago, they did a really fun episode on Monet and his gardens and how that all happened and how it's being preserved. We also got to go to the installation of his water lily panels in Paris by the Louvre in the Orangerie, and it is amazing to stand right there next to the canvases and look at his brush strokes and see the layers and the depth and the scribbles, and it was just fascinating. And the more we sat, the more mesmerizing it became. They seemed to represent the different seasons and times of day. Two different rooms, I believe one was the seasons and one was the times of day. Huge panels all around. It's like a big, huge oval, floor to ceiling. It's so beautiful. He was one of the very first impressionists. Here's one of our first sunflowers, and they grow so fast. It's like every day you see change. One time I found this picture of pink sunflowers. This isn't mine, but I thought for sure this was fake. But I went looking and I found seeds for pink sunflowers, and they're coming along. I'm so excited. I can hardly wait to see. I found two different kinds of seeds and have them all planted. It's going to be so pretty. I love the bird baths. And there's the blue flax growing kind of wild in the background behind the bed. Cosmos are so fun for the bouquets, and I love their ferny little leaves. They're so pretty. Pretty in bouquets. And they grow all summer. They flower all summer, which is fun. Peonies only once. I think they're just so beautiful. So fragrant. I really love the white and pink. And they dry really well too, really beautifully, and last a long, long time dried. I just hang mine upside down. I heard that you can take the buds and put them in a paper bag in the refrigerator and save them for weeks or months and then have peonies much later. So I might try that. So here are the lower beds of our little lower greenhouse that I thrifted the frame of for $15, and it's so sturdy and anchored. And then new beds in there last year, kind of raised off the ground. It went insane last year, so I was waiting to see what reseeded, and I have a lot of thinning to do. These are mostly planted this year with cucumbers and squash. I'm hoping the cucumbers will grow and climb the wire mesh that lines the inside of that one. These grow right outside of our bed there by the blue flax. These are last year's, one of our David Austin roses, but they're coming along beautifully. Can't wait. Here's our little garden house with our flying pig weather vane. I don't know what this plant is, but it comes in a wild seed packet. I could do that plant Google thing. They're so pretty. And here are some wilting peonies, still beautiful. This is a double apple cherry, apple blossom, double apple blossom geranium that I have kept going for years and years. And I love these ornamental cabbages in the garden. A couple years ago, I tried to salvage and save and dry a bunch of them because they're so beautiful, but it stunk up the house too bad. And they wouldn't dry, so it was gonna be a stinky process. I love zinnias. Zinnias, they have such a variety of fun, cheerful, happy flowers. I keep thinking that's a sunflower, but back to zinnias, they have such fun individual little faces and blooms. They're just funny and sweet and adorable. Speaking of happiness in summer, I would love to recommend a book to read or audible. At Home in Mitford by Jan Caron or Carone. I'm listening to the audible and it is such a sweet, sweet, wonderful story in the midst of a very messed up world and culture and society, and even in the midst of a lot of grief and pain and cruelty in our own lives, the garden, the zinnias, sweet stories are so helpful. Like The Magic of Ordinary Days, if you haven't watched that movie, it's free on YouTube with ads. I think it's a Hallmark movie. It's based on a true story, The Magic of Ordinary Days. So I hope that you will enjoy those.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions, and rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it. passion, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Who said that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star? Somebody thought of that, and someone believed it. Look what it's done so far. What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? And what do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. All of us under its spell, we know that it's probably magic. Have you been half asleep, and have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name. Is this the sweet sound that calls the young sailors? The voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me.
Thank you for joining me.